Wilco Kelderman, journeyman World Tour top 10 getter, returns back to Jumbo Visma. But this show, as always, is brought to you by Zwift. Zwift Academy is back for 2022. Registration is open now. Whether you're aiming for a pro contract like Jay Vine or Neve Branfrey, or just looking to kickstart your fitness with some structured sessions, Zwift Academy will help you get fitter and have more fun on the bike. There are 6 workouts to complete, either solo or in-group workouts with baseline rides to compare your progress before and after Zwift Academy. He was on Lotto NL Jumbo. He's on Belkin, Rabobank Continental back in the day. Wilco Kelderman, 3rd in GC at the Giro 2020, 4th in the Vuelta 2017, 5th at the Tour 2021 last year. Good results. So many top 10s. Like, he's got that crazy statistic about how many World Tour top 10s he has without a win, especially for a guy. He's not Kreuzweig. He's quite fast in a punchy uphill sprint. That's what's crazy. But if you look at the Circuito de Getxo finish, you see why he hasn't won. What role do you see for him, Benji? Because Jumbo-Visma, they got the headliners. Roglic, Vingegaard, who else for GC? Omen's not it. Kreuzweig's folded into a domestique
Foss
role. Foss hasn't shown it. Did they kind Gelderman of need another guy for a Giro?
Gelderman is the perfect man for that spot. And we had a team of Dumoulin and Foss going to the Giro. The Foss experiment, I wouldn't say it's completely bottled yet. I think if you try him at 1 week races and try him again at a Grand Tour as a secondary GC rider, co-leader, for example, with Kelderman at the Giro, that is something I would like to see happen. And if Foss doesn't prove himself there, he can fall into a domestique role for Kelderman. But I see Kelderman as the GC leader for the Giro next year, because in my opinion, they should still send Vingegaard and Roglic both to the Tour de France. That's my take. We might see next year if that happens or does not happen. Now, I also think that Kelderman should be in the Tour de France team next year, and he should be a domestique, because yep, that's an extra mountain yep rider added to there. I know that when the Van Baarle discussion happened earlier, that you mentioned that the team should stay the same. You probably forgot that Kelderman was being signed, because I think you agree that he should be in the team.
It depends who. He'll be fighting Kreuzweig for that position. There's Kuss, Benoit, I forgot, Van Hooydonk, Laporte. It depends on the parkour. I mean, if there's no cobbled stage, Benji, do you need all of Van Hooydonk, Laporte, Van Aert, Benoit for rouleurs?
Yeah.
Like, if it's not in Denmark, if it starts in the Basque Country next year, do you want Kelderman replace, I don't know. That's something to, you know, it depends on the parkour. But yeah, like Foss, Benji, he's had 30 race days this year and didn't get taken to a Vuelta that abounds with 5-7% climbs for a bigger guy like him as a domestique. And the Jumbo Visma Vuelta team, no offense, but it ain't their Tour de France team
yeah
either. And Foss didn't make the cut for that team. He's 25. He's turning 26 next year. And Dumoulin's retired. It's pretty clear that they're shallow in GC and top level. Even like Kreuzweig, he's crashed a lot, but he did well on Solaison. But I think there's Kreuzweig, Kuss as climbing domestiques, and then not too much else. So the Kelderman yeah signing just makes a lot of sense. And from his perspective, Benji,
mm-hmm,
I would be thinking, I want to win a race. I still have the legs. Like, I want to get some wins on the board. So it makes sense that he's going to Jumbo Visma, I guess, for that.
Yeah, I think so as well. I think he's going to win races at Jumbo Visma, at least one. Come on, we finally got to have the Kelderman victory. Whether they send him to like Tour de Hungary or something, I don't care.
No, they should. If I was in charge of his, like, I would get him. Get the guys just some easy win, like some easy mental victories. I think
open the floodgates.
Yeah.
And then the Kelderman wins will keep flowing in one by one throughout the season.
It's like Almeida Polonia last year. Remember, before Polonia, he kept, yeah, he was like, how's this guy not winning races? And then open the floodgates.
Well, has he won that much since?
He won two the week before, right? I said he can't. You said he's a useless, winless.
I did not say that. You invented that. You invented
he won two
that
Bologna stages and GC, I think.
I did not say that statement. I deny it. But I think this does have a factor or an influence on the other part of Jumbo-Visma. We look at Olaf Kooi being in this team, David Dekker not re-signed yet from what I can tell. And I'd argue that David Dekker does not fit in the team of Jumbo anymore.
No.
I don't mean that harshly towards David Dekker or anything, but we've got a Grand Tour squad for the Tour de France that will not have a sprinter in it because Wout van Aert can take Green and be a domestique. So Olaf Kooi is the best sprinter on Jumbo-Visma. They should send him to the Giro combined with Kelderman, in my opinion. Sorry, yep. But Olaf Kooi deserves a Grand Tour with flat sprints in it because he's going to win a Grand Tour stage next year if they send him to a Grand Tour. Now, the issue that I see is David Dekker. Yeah, he's got no opportunities there. But if you're Olaf Kooi, at what point are you going to say, I don't want to be the guy that goes to the Giro and the Vuelta for Grand Tour stage wins? I want to go to the Tour de France. Is that in 2 years? And you're like, okay, they have to start choosing between Wout van Aert and Kooi then, or am I thinking too far?
That's a 2024 discussion, which is his contract is last year is next year. He's 20 years old. He's won his first World Tour stage this year. I don't think it's a pretty, you need a big a big set of cojones to be like a Primoz and Jonas. You pretty good tour this year, but I would like three lead out rides and Tour de France. I would like to go for my chances with Wout and the team. So I don't really see that as a discussion, at least coming up this year. I think Giro fits. I would send a split squad of Tosh van der Sande, Dennis, Kelderman, Foss maybe, plus Kooi and one of the Van Dijk brothers. I mean, you've seen
in... Bauman.
Bauman, sorry. You've seen a Tour of Denmark. When Kooi has Laporte as a leader, it's like, I know it's not Tour de France sprint, but it's not even close. I think they should sign a proper last man for him. I don't know if Affini is that guy. I think Affini at the Giro is a fine setup man, but a proper last man. Can Rosen do it? I'd like to see them get a specialist in for Olaf Kooi. But Kelderman, I mean, he crashes a lot. They got Kreuzweig, Kelderman, Roglic. I think he podiums the Giro, and I think he wins a random TT. Yeah, we'll see. Kelderman uphill can go super, super fast. He's in ice weight for it as a domestique. I think it's a fine signing.